Hello everyone. Today we will see temperature factor. In previous lecture we were in load factor. Okay. So for pure axial load factor is 0.7, and for bending, pure bending, combined loading, and pure torsion it is 1. So the next is temperature factor. Account for the difference between the test temperature and operating temperature. For carbon and alloy steels, fatigue strength not affected by operating temperature, -45 to 450 degrees Celsius, this temperature factor is equal to 1. At higher operating temperature, Ke is equal to C. For temperature between 450 to 550 degrees Celsius, its value of Ke is equal to 1 minus 5800 into T minus 450, that is the factor 450 to 550, T minus 450, this factor into 5800. Okay, this total factor 1 minus this total factor is equal to Ke. And for temperature below 450 degrees Celsius up to minus 45 degrees Celsius, the Ke will be 1. Again, for temperature between 840 degree Fahrenheit to 1020 degree Fahrenheit, the temperature factor will be 1 minus 3200 T minus 840. Okay, so this is the formula for temperature factor. Okay, now this is a very short design procedure given for fully reversible loading for infinite length. Okay, this is very short design procedure. So due to time constraint, as we don't have much time to complete the syllabus, due to time constraint, please see VV Bhandari book or any textbook of machine design 1 to understand the design procedure. It is not that simple and not that difficult also, but understanding, you can understand by yourself. Okay. Once you understand, it is easy to you can solve the numericals also. The design for finite type. So for finite life is the life before 10 raised to 6 cycles. Okay, so the equation of this particular line, 10 raised to 6 cycle, means this line. Okay, and this equation is, this line is a, seems on logarithmic scale, this line is seems to be straight line, but it is actually a exponential line. So the curve will be, curve of this, the equation of this curve will be exponential, which is small a into n raised to small b. Okay, so the strength will be, Sn will be a into n raised to b. Okay, so we see the numericals from machine design book. I will share notes for this module number 4 on WhatsApp from the book VV Bhandari. And see the design procedure and numerical also to, and check how these numericals are solved. Design for finite life, this is the equation for exponential curve converted to logarithmic. So equation of straight line is obtained. And from that, constant a, small b is obtained. Okay. And strength, that is fatigue value, fatigue limit or endurance limit. From value of endurance limit, the value, strength value at given number of cycles can be obtained from this formula. Okay. See, this is the straight line equation. This is the straight line equation in logarithmic term, and from that small n small b is calculated. Small n small b is put in here in this formula, and value of SN, that is strength at n number of cycles, is obtained from endurance limit value. And once endurance limit value is known, you can get the value of strength at any number of cycle. Okay. So SUT is the ultimate tensile strength. N is the number of cycles. Calculate SN and replace SE in the design equation. Okay. So that in design equation, to calculate the sigma A value, use this equation, that is SN upon n small n is equal to sigma A into KF, where KF is the particular factor. Now we will see fluctuating stresses. The failure points from fatigue test made with different steels and combination of mean and variable stresses are plotted in figure as functions of stress amplitude, that is sigma A, and mean stress sigma A. Mean stress is the average of sigma max and sigma min, and stress amplitude is the difference between maximum stress and minimum stress upon 2. Okay, that is the, it is the height from mean stress value to the maximum stress value, or mean stress value to the minimum stress value. Okay, so the fatigue points of fatigue test made with different steel and combination of mean and variable stresses are plotted in figure as function of sigma A and sigma B, sigma N. The most significant observation is that in general the failure point is little related to mean stress when it is compressive, but is very much a function of mean stress when it is tensile. So in case of for compressive, it is related to stress amplitude, that is sigma A, and in case of tensile stress, it is related to mean stress, that is sigma A. In practice, this means that fatigue failures are rare when the mean stress is compressive or negative. So, in case of compressive stresses, fatigue failure is very rare. Therefore, the greater emphasis must be given to the combination of variable stress and steady, that is mean tensile. So we will see the graph of sigma A and sigma A. So, graph of stress amplitude and mean stress. So on this graph, various this is the graph of alternating stress versus mean stress value. See, in this graph there are various lines and one curve is there. This line is straight line connecting SY and SY on alternating stress axis and mean stress axis. Okay, this is a straight line. This straight line is a yield line. So according to this line, yield line, according to this line, the region below this line is safe. That means that if alternating stress value is below SY value and mean stress value is also below SY value, then the member will be safe. Else, if one of these values is above the SY value, then member will failed under given condition. Okay, that means that the below line, the area below this line, in line, will be safe. So this is the theory of in line. Okay, now another theory is Gerber curve. Okay, this is green curve is a Gerber curve. According to this theory, if the alternating stress value is less than AC, okay, that is endurance limit value, and mean stress value is less than ACUT, then the specimen will be safe. Okay. So Gerber curve is the curve joining AC, that is for endurance limit, on alternating stress axis and ultimate tensile strength value on mean stress axis. Okay, so this is a curve. Gerber curve is a curve. The safe region is lower region, lower area of that curve, and the area above that curve will be unsafe region. Likewise, this is a Goodman line. This red line is a Goodman line connecting AC on alternating stress and ACUT on mean stress. Okay, so this straight line says that below area below this straight line is safe. Okay, if the value of alternating stress and mean stress comes under this area, then the specimen will be safe. That means that if the value of sigma a, that is stress amplitude, is less than AC and mean stress value is less than ACUT, then the specimen will be safe. So this is the Goodman line theory. Now again, fourth theory is Soderbergh's theory. Okay, according to this, the line is AC, that is one point is AC, that is on a straight on a alternating stress axis, the endurance limit is the one point, and on mean stress axis, Sy is the another point. Okay, so according to this theory, Soderbergh's theory, if the point is come, point means the value of alternating stress is equal to less than AC, and value of mean stress is equal to less than Sy. Okay, so the point will come under this line. Okay, if the point is come under this line, then the specimen will be safe, else the specimen will be unsafe. Okay, so there are total three lines and one curve. So these are the various theories for fluctuating stresses. First one is Goodman method for combination of stresses. A straight line connecting, so we will see in detail about these various line and curve. Goodman method for combination of stresses. A straight line connecting the endurance limit sigma e and the ultimate strength sigma e, as shown by line AB in figure given below, follows the suggestion of Goodman. A Goodman line is used when the design is based on ultimate strength and may be used for ductile or brittle material. So this particular theory is used for ductile or brittle material. So here, see, on y axis variable stress axis, on x is the mean stress axis. So this is the graph, and the line joining sigma e on variable stress axis, sigma u on mean stress axis is the Goodman line. Okay, and so the region below this line will be safe region. Further part we will discuss in next lecture.